Good afternoon. My name is Christopher Schindler. I'm at the First Congregational United Church of Christ in Vancouver, Washington. The organ here is a Johannes Opus 370, which was acquired in 2014. For this year's Bach-a-Thon, I'm playing two chorale preludes from the Orgelbuch line, Durch Adams Fall ist ganz verderbt, or Adams, Old Adam's Fall Corrupted All, as translated in my edition, and Ich ruf zu dir, Herr Jesu Christ, which is I call to thee, Lord Jesus Christ. And my final piece will be the prelude from the Prelude and Fugue, BWV 546 in C minor.
Thank you. Matthew O'Sullivan, Subdean of the Portland Chapter of the American Guild of Organists. I hope you're enjoying this showcase for the many and varied talents of our chapter's members, featuring the music of the greatest organ composer of all. As a cathedral chorister growing up in England, I had the best possible opportunities to develop an interest in the pipe organ at an impressionable age. At 6 services every week, I was able to experience the many colours of the Guildford Cathedral organ, from the softest atmospherics to the tutti moments that seemed to shake the whole building. Long before I was tall enough or accomplished enough on a keyboard to start lessons, I knew that this captivating instrument would be part of my life. And when I did start to play, playing in high school assembly every morning, and the prospect of a scholarship to a good university were extremely effective in keeping me motivated to practice and get better. I was fortunate to have all these opportunities served up to me, but few students are in that position, and the fact is we need to do whatever we can to make sure that the magic of the organ touches the lives of more people. One of the ways that Portland AGO helps in this effort is by keeping a scholarship fund. Students can apply for scholarships which are available to cover the cost of a year's organ lessons with a teacher who is a member of the Portland AGO chapter. The money goes directly to the teacher without middlemen or overheads. So as part of this Bach-a-Thon program, we invite you to make a donation to the scholarship fund. You can scan the QR code on this screen or use the link in the description section on YouTube. The money you donate will bring a new generation into closer contact with the King of Instruments. Please give generously and enjoy the rest of the program.
Thank you. My name is Heidi Cohn, and I am the organist at Rose City Park Presbyterian Church, which is located on Northeast Sandy in Portland. The organ I am playing on is a three-manual Rogers Trillium instrument that is completely digital. I am playing Allein Gott in der Höhe sei er from Klavierübung Volume 3. This is one of the large-scale settings that is in G major, BWV 676. This is in the form of more of a trio sonata, whereby each hand has a separate line and the pedals are having a bopping line bass throughout the piece. I tried to solo out the melody as much as I could, which is a little bit harder to find sometimes. Thank you for watching the Bach-a-Thon, and I hope that you give generously to our scholarship fund. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Greg DeSantis, and I live in the small town of Turner, Oregon, just southeast of Salem. And today I've chosen to perform the Prelude and Fugue in A minor, BWV 543, on my Hauptwerk installation, Hauptwerk version 6. And the sample set I'm using is the St. Maximin sample set from Sonus Paradisi. It's a French Baroque instrument built in 1775 with four manuals and 44 stops. So I hope you'll enjoy my performance. Thank you. Thank you.
addition to regular chapter programming like today's Bach-a-Thon, the American Guild of Organists also puts on conventions every summer, either national ones, like last year in Seattle, or regional ones, like this year here in Portland. As the 2023 West Regional Convention Coordinator, I would like to invite you to attend this year's convention, July 10th through 13th. With the theme of Let's Dance, the convention includes workshops on various aspects of dancing, from incorporating liturgical dance in church, to Baroque dances, to using movement to enhance musicality. The closing concert will feature organist Pamela Decker premiering a work she's composed for organ and dancers to be held at First United Methodist Church downtown. Other workshops include techniques for choir directors on the aging voice, an organ masterclass with George Ritchie, and an overview of the Portland AGO chapter's history. The convention will also feature two dance-related keynote speeches by Pamela Decker and Kimberly Marshall. Local performers will include A Silent Movie of the Marco Zoo with Jonas Nordwall, Soon Min Oh at St. Mary's Catholic Cathedral, Dr. Katie Webb and the Trinity Choir with our opening worship service at Trinity Episcopal Cathedral, and Capella Romana providing a Greek Orthodox worship service at the Grotto. There's quite a bit of time for some personal relaxation and renewal as well, and there will also be plenty of opportunities to make new friends on the buses. So join us at the Crown Plaza Hotel, July 10th through 13th, and head to agowest2023.com for all the details and to register. We hope to welcome you here in the Rose City.
Thank you. Hello, I'm Matthew O'Sullivan. I am the organist and director of music at St. Bart's Episcopal Church in Beaverton and the organist at Lewis and Clark College. I am at Lewis and Clark tonight playing the less famous of the organs. This is the 1977 Carl Wilhelm in the studio. And I will be playing the G major sitting of Allein Gott in der Herse Er from the 18 chorale preludes. Thank you.
Sandy Wilson. I will be playing the fugue in B-flat major, BWV 560. Be playing at Augustana Lutheran Church, the Marceau Opus 3 organ, with 36 stops and 24 ranks.
Oh! Good afternoon. My name is Stephen Jansen. I'm the organist at Beautiful Savior Lutheran Church in Vancouver, Washington. I'm going to be playing for you today the Dorian Toccata and Fugue in D minor, BWV 538. This piece was composed during Bach's Weimar period that took place from 1708 to 1717. This piece is nicknamed the Dorian Toccata and Fugue in D minor, referring to the fact that the piece is written without a key signature, which leads one to assume the Dorian mode. The toccata features an opening 16th note motif that is heard nearly uninterrupted to the end of the toccata. There are also elaborate concertato effects, and Bach even indicates manual changes in several places, an unusual practice for his day. The fugue subject prominently features syncopation and three upward leaps of a perfect fourth. The time signature is a la breve and features a rhythmic pattern of the eighth note rather than the 16th note pattern that is prevalent in many of Bach's fugues. The fugue features the use of chromaticism, harmonic suspensions, and a nearly constant succession of the subject and answer. This is the Toccata and Fugue in D minor, BWV 538, nicknamed the Dorian.